interpreting the regression line. Remember, y hat is equal to 20.47 plus 0.3736x. What is x? X is age. And uni is how many months old? And what's y? Y is height, okay? Uni is inches, okay, inches. So if you give me an x, I want to predict y, okay? And we find this is the best prediction line based on what? The given data set, okay? Now, our next job. Explain in simple language, what is the slope of this regression line tell us? What's the meaning of this number? 0.3736. Mathematician will tell you like this, okay? For each unit increase in x, resulting 0.3736 in 0.3736 what? Unit increase in y. But that's too mathematical, okay? If a person don't have a mathematics training, we will not appreciate this kind of interpretation, okay? So how you explain this one in simple language, okay? Even those people did not go to school, they can understand, okay? Now, in simple language, you know the slope is the ray concept, okay? Slope is a ray concept. So we should say on average, okay? Slope is a ray concept or average concept. So we say on average, John Blue, 0.3736 inches per month during the study period. What's a study period? From 36 months old, that's 3 years old, to what? To 66 months old, okay? 5 years and a half. If you explain like that, everybody can what? Can understand, okay? Okay, next one. Prediction error, or you say residuals. A residual is the difference between an observed value of the response variable and the value predicted by regression line. That is, residual is observed y subtract by predicted y. Y minus y hat, that's a prediction error, okay? Now, for example, we can ask, what is a prediction error? What is the residual of age 4? In John's case, okay? Look at here. 4 years old, that is equivalent to what? 48 months old. Look at the previous one, data set. When John was 48 months old, how tall was John? 38 inches tall, okay? John was not very tall. The observed y value is what? Is 38 inches tall. Okay? Now, if we use this one as a prediction line, okay? Say we want to predict x, when x, or we want to predict y, we want to predict y. Y hat means we want to predict y, okay? When x is what? 48 months old. 20.47 plus 0.3736x. And you plug in x equal to what? 48. What do you get? You get 38.40, okay? So the prediction error is what you observe subtract by what you predict. In John's case, observe value of y, 38 inches tall, okay? The predicted value, 38.40. The difference minus 0.4 inches. Look at here. Prediction error. Okay? Residual. Carry. Direction. Okay? If it's greater than zero, that means what? That means observed value is bigger than what? Predicted value. Okay? Less than zero, that means observed value is what? Less than predicted value. Okay? So residual carry direction. Okay? So residual carry direction. Let me try one more time. Observed value is 38. Predict value is 38.40. End up with prediction error is minus 0.4 inches. Minus tell you the direction, okay? If residual greater than zero, that means observed value greater than predicted value. Observed value is four or what? It's on the top, is, well, if this is your prediction line, right? Positive residual means what? The prediction line, this is a predicted value. And this is what? Observed value. Observed value fall on the top of the prediction line. Therefore, the prediction error is positive. Okay? So that's why we say residual carry direction. Make sure you should keep the sign. Okay? So people know the point is above the prediction line or below the prediction line. When it's below the prediction line, prediction error is less than zero. Okay? Okay, look at question number three. John's parents decides to use the least square regression line of John's height on age based on the data. Predict his height at age 21 years old, which is 252 months old. What conclusion can we draw? Okay, look at here. Y hat given X is 21 years old, that is 252 months old. Plug in our formula, 20.47 plus 0.3736x. x, you plug in what? 252. So what do you get? You get 114.16 inches. Okay? You're probably not that familiar with inches. Let me convert it for you, okay? 114.6 inches. 1 inch is 2.54 centimeter. So this is 291, about centimeter. Remember I told you when John was small, John was not very tall. But when he come to what? 21 years old, he will become a giant. 291 centimeter. Is that right? That's wrong, okay? Why this is wrong? Human being, because gravity and what? Human being's bone structure. Human being simply cannot be what? This tall, okay? So where we make a mistake? Let's look at the picture here, okay? This is X, X is H. Okay? And this is Y. Y is the height. Remember when you were just born, you grew very fast. Then what happened? Slow down. You know, human beings baby, right? In the first year, the length can be what? Double. And then slow down. And then stabilized. You know, when human beings, they come to Scott's age, they what? They shrink. Okay, so human growth is not a straight line, it's a curve, okay? However, because we collect the data from 36 months old to what? 66 months old, In this period of time, data reflect what? A very strong linear trend, okay? And Jones' parents, they just extend this line to what? To 252 months old, okay? Then you put the projection back. What do you get? What do you get? You get this is what? 114.6. See? This part is a power overestimate. Is that okay? So what do you learn from this example? This is called extrapolation, okay? This given X is what? 252 months old. Is far beyond the data range of X. Okay? The correct data. The data corrected only from what? 36 months old to 66 months old. Okay? When you want to predict an X that is far beyond the data range of X, this prediction is called extrapolation. The prediction is called extrapolation, okay? Extrapolation is a prediction far beyond the data range, the correct data range. And since far beyond the correct data range, this kind of prediction has no support for what? From the data, okay? Okay, let me repeat. What's extrapolation? What's extrapolation? The prediction made is far beyond the correct data range of X. Without supporting data, extrapolation is risky. And most of the time, it is simply wrong. Is that it? So don't use it. Okay, next, let's look at facts about least square regression, or you say property of least square regression. Property one, the distinction between explanatory and response variable is essential in regression, but not essential in correlation. Okay? What does that mean? Let's look at the example here. This is X, this is Y. Say X is 1, 2, 3. Y is 2, 4, 4. Okay? And R1. And another table. X, Y. X is 2, 4, 4. X is 1, 2, 3. And the correlation is R2. Okay? Now, recall, what's the formula to compute R? R is what? R is 1 over N minus 1. Summation X minus average X divided by standard deviation X and times Y minus average Y divided by standard deviation Y. Okay? Look at here. This is the formula we compute R, right? What's the difference between these two tables? In the first table, X is 1, 2, 3. Y is 2, 4, 4. In second table, X is 2, 4, 4. Y is 1, 2, 3. So what you used to call X, now you change the name as Y. What you used to call Y, now you call it what? X. In other words, X and Y current swap. Look at the formula. Whenever you see X, you replace by Y. Whenever you see Y, you replace by X. So what happened to R? You know, 2 times 3 is 3 times 2, right? Order doesn't matter. So for sure, R1 equal to R2. So in correlation, which one you call X, which one you call Y, doesn't matter, okay? Doesn't matter. But this is not the case for regression, okay? In regression, we focus on what? Prediction, okay? We focus on prediction. Y hat equal to A plus BX. For a given X, we want to what? Want to predict Y. For a given X, we want to predict Y, okay? For a given X, we want to predict Y. So X is given. Y is the one you want to predict. That distinction is what is essential. Okay? Okay, let's look at property 2. There is a close connection between correlation and the slope of the least square regression line. Okay? Recall, this is a formula we use to find what? The best prediction line, the regression line. How we find the slope? It's correlation times standard deviation Y over standard deviation X. When people give us the data set, the bivariate data set, to study the data set, we make the graph first, okay? If we find the graph is football shaped, okay? Then what can we say? We find, it suggests that there's a linear relationship between X and Y. So in more advanced course, they call this is what? X, Y follow joined by very normal distribution. And that is when you make projection towards X direction. That means you surrender the Y coordinates. You only look at what? X coordinates. Those data points will form what? A normal distribution. Center at X bar, okay? Same thing, if you make projection against what? Vertical axis, the center is Y bar. Make projection against what? Vertical axis, that means you surrender the X coordinates, okay? You will find data in Y direction, also from a normal distribution, centered at Y bar, okay? This is, so when you see hear people say football shape, that means what? In more advanced material, they may call this is XY follow, joined by a very normal distribution, okay? This is the center, X bar, Y bar is the center. And this is what? The spread around the center. The spread around the center. And from this formula, okay, from this formula, what do you know? You say regression slope is found by correlation times standard deviation Y over standard deviation X. So case one. If standard deviation Y is roughly equal to standard deviation X, then look at here. When you look at the X direction spread and Y direction spread is about the same, okay? It's about the same. B equal to R. The regression slope is the correlation coefficient. Okay, so there's a nice one, physical interpretation for R. What's correlation coefficient? The correlation coefficient is when you make the scalar plot, you find this is football shape, okay? There's a linear relationship between X and Y. When there's a linear relationship between X and Y, and you check in the X direction and Y direction, the spread is about the same. Then, what's correlation coefficient? The correlation coefficient is a slope of the best fitted line to the given data set, okay? This is a physical interpretation of correlation. Let me try one more time, okay? when linear model is applied to the given data set, okay, well, you say XY follower joined by very normal distribution. And you find spread in X direction and Y direction are about the same, okay? Then correlation coefficient is the slope of what? The best fitted line to the given data set, okay? That's a physical interpretation. Now, case two. Even if standard deviation Y is nowhere close to standard deviation X, we still look at the formula. B is equal to R times standard deviation Y over standard deviation X. Since both of them are positive, okay? So this is a positive number. Since this is a positive number, when R is negative, B is negative. When I is positive, B is positive. That is to say, B and R have what? The same direction. Okay? Even though the spread in both directions, they are nowhere close, we can still say what? There's a close connection between regression slope and correlation coefficient. When R is positive, positive slope, positive association. When R is negative, negative association, okay? The relationship between R and B is what? Very close, okay? Okay, property three. The least square regression line always passes through what? The point of averages. Average X, average Y. Okay? Now recall. Say this line, Y equal to MX plus B. Okay? And this is something you learn in high school. Given a point, X not, Y not. How do you know this point will fall on the line? How do you know that? Well, it's very easy. All you need to do is check. If when you plug in what? Why not here? To see whether why not equal to mx not plus b. Okay? If this is yes, then the point x not y not is on the line. If this is not equal, then X not, Y not is not on the line. That's what you learned from high school, right? Now, we can apply the same concept here. Say this line is the regression line. Y hat equal to what? A plus BX, okay? How do we know X bar, Y bar is on the line? How do we know this X bar, Y bar is on the line? Very easy, just check. X bar, to see this is equal to A plus B X bar or not, okay? But to check this is equivalent to check. If you move this term to this side, okay, to check y bar minus bx bar to see whether this is equal to A or not. A is what? A is y intercept. Remember how we find y intercept? This is a formula. This is a formula we use to find what? Y intercept. So when you use the formula, you already agree that regression line pass through what? X bar, Y bar, okay?